I think that our research has tackled this from a number of different perspectives. The first is just looking at what barriers still exist to the deployment of autonomous vehicles. And there are a lot of challenges that still remain. While there have been a lot of technological advances in terms of sensors, in terms of image recognition and processing that allow these vehicles to navigate, they still don't operate very well in poor weather conditions, in extremely complex urban environments where they really can encounter many different types of context scenarios. There are also a lot of regulatory barriers. We still really lack a comprehensive set of rules for governing the deployment of these vehicles, for governing their safety, and in particular looking at sort of how safety drivers, or in the future, teleoperators, people that can sort of oversee the autonomous vehicles, are going to be required or are going to be structured. And these have very different implications for the business models for deploying these autonomous vehicles. We also looked at the implications for the introduction of really low-cost autonomous door-to-door mobility services. So the idea is, do you take something like an Uber or Lyft service where you hail a car and it takes you from your origin to your destination, but you deploy this at scale with autonomous vehicles that can really reduce the cost on a trip-by-trip basis for individuals? And we looked at how this would change how people decide what mode they're gonna take, how they're gonna go from their origin to their destination, from home to work, from work to the bar late at night, from the bar to home. And what we've found is that in general, these services, if they're just introduced without further regulation, are likely to compete with existing public transit services. They're going to reduce public transit ridership much more than they would reduce mobility by private vehicles. And so the idea is you're actually going to be adding more cars to the road, and you're going to be adding more car trips, so miles traveled by cars in our cities. And this is a finding that we've found across simulations of different types of cities. So it doesn't matter what the incumbent level of public transit use is. You can have a really auto-oriented city. You can have a really dense city with a robust transit network, something like New York City. And you still see that the introduction of these robo-taxi systems would increase congestion and increase car miles traveled. Now, if you introduce these services along with policies that require them to serve as first or last mile access to public transit networks, so you better integrate them with existing public transit networks, you can gain a lot of mobility without some of those negative consequences.